Welcome to Snowflake 101. In this video, we will be explaining time travel, a Snowflake feature that allows users to access previous states of their data. We'll be covering what is time travel, the requirements to use this feature, and when to use it, with examples. If you've ever accidentally deleted data, or worse, an entire database, time travel can help you go back in time to reclaim them. Time travel is a tool that allows you to go back and restore data-related objects, duplicate and back up past data, and analyze data usage over a specific period of time. Here are some examples of using time travel inside Snowflake. There are two ways to do it in queries, using at and before. At is used to go back to a specific time and date. Select from your table at the timestamp. Meanwhile, if you just need to go back some specific amount of time from right now, use at with offset. If you don't know the exact time you want to go back, use before to go back to the state right before your disaster. Grab the query ID from your query history of when your disaster happened and use select from your table before the query ID. You can also combine Snowflake zero copy cloning with time travel to get a copy of your database, table, or schema from the past. You can do this using a clone at or clone before statement. Lastly, you can even use the undrop statement to recover from accidental data deletion. Time travel does impact storage costs, and you can disable it if desired by setting the retention time to zero. But be careful doing so, because you will permanently lose the data or objects in your account that may have been accidentally dropped. For more information on using time travel, check out the links in the description box down below. I'm Diana Pham, and this has been another episode of Snowflake 101. See you in the data cloud.